Welcome back. You're watching India This Morning. Let's now shift focus to the latest developments as far as Jammu and Kashmir is concerned. Now, India's National Security Advisor Ajit Doval made an attempt to reach out to the locals. PM Modi's close aide has been in the valley now for the last few days, overseeing the government's groundwork after the state's special status was taken away. In fact, on Tuesday, he also interacted with locals in Shopian and shared a meal with them. He also met the JNK police personnel to thank them for their efforts.
हमको मालूम है कि सीआरपी जो फोर्स है हमारे देश की उसमें पूरे देश को बहुत जो ड्यूटीज आपने की हैं छोटी से लेके बड़ी से बड़ी ड्यूटी पर पूरे हिंदुस्तान के अंदर में कोई ऐसा जगह नहीं है जहां पर अगर समस्या आई हो या जहां पर राष्ट्र को जरूरत पड़ी हो अपने बल की और अपने उसकी प्रयोग करने की जहां पर सीआरपी नहीं है चाहे वो इलेक्शन हो चाहे वो फ्लड हो चाहे वो लॉ हो चाहे कॉम्यूनल राइट्स हो और जहाँ जहाँ वो गई है जिस कामयाबी से उसने अपना फर्ज निभाया वो हम सब के लिए उसका विषय है कश्मीर के अंदर में विशेष परिस्थिति कश्मीर और लेफ्ट विंग एक्सट्रीमिस्ट एरिया के अंदर में ये दो खास जगह हैं जहाँ पर सीआरपी के लोगों ने बहुत उत्कृष्ट सेवा दी है जहाँ पर आप लोगों ने जो सेवा की है उसका कोई मुकाबला नहीं आप लोगों का डिसिप्लिन आप लोगों का मोरल आप लोगों की हिम्मत हौसले और आप लोगों की लीडरशिप है इस सब पे हमें बड़ा फख्र है और मेरा तो खैर सीआरपी से क्योंकि मैं पुलिस डिपार्टमेंट से 52 साल से मैं वो रहा हूँ कई बार कई लोगों के साथ में कई यूनिट के साथ में काम करने का भी मौका मिला है मिलने का भी मौका मिला है
Well, meanwhile, Jammu and Kashmir Governor Satya Pal Malik has reviewed the arrangements ahead of Eid. Mandis will be set up at different locations to facilitate people. Ration shops, grocery and medicine stores have been asked to remain open on the occasion. Governor has also issued directions to facilitate Kashmiri students living in other states to return home for Eid celebrations. Directions have also been issued to set up telephone lines in the Deputy Commissioner's office for outstation students who cannot return home for Eid. Let's in fact go across to Farid, who's joining us from Srinagar. Farid, obviously, there are several issues here. One is, of course, the shutdown remains in force as far as the valley is concerned. The second point that the government is leaving no stone unturned to ensure that to connect with people, to connect with the forces who are on ground at this point in time. If you can just help us understand what's really going on right now.
Well, the situation remains tense, Avni. There's no doubt about it. On the ground, you can really sense that there is tension on the ground. People are under a lockdown. They are in their homes. They are absolutely incommunicado. There is no communication that they can resort to, which is pretty unprecedented in today's day and age. But such were the circumstances. Such was the fare, as far as the government is concerned, of a backlash of something going terribly wrong as far as law and order in the Kashmir Valley is concerned. And that's why they resorted to what we saw. I mean, the kind of restrictions. Now, it is, let me tell you, it's an enforced calm. Let there be no two ways about it. It's enforced calm, which is being enforced. Calm is being enforced. But the big challenge for the government would be that once they lift these restrictions, the kind of reaction that they'll get. So that is the other big day. But today and for the coming days as well, it seems that restrictions are the fate as far as the people of Jammu and Kashmir, or should I say people of the valleys, are concerned. People, we do not have any connection. Let me tell you, I do not know what's happening in the districts. Even in Srinagar, there is absolutely no way you'll get to know what exactly is happening in the interiors. There is complete barricading, though the governor has come out and said that for Eid they are making preparations. But who will trust the governor? I mean, he's the same governor who, before repealing of 370, kept on coming on record, trying to suggest that all is well. There is absolutely no need to worry. 35A, 370 won't be touched. So if he's the same governor, so it is very difficult to see people really reposing their trust in him or trying to believe what he's trying to suggest. So that really is the other factor that the government will have to ensure that they come over, because there is a huge trust deficit now between the common man and the government, because that's something that has developed developed or in fact increased in the last 1 week before the repealing of Article 370. The governor, we know that he came in on record a number of times saying that everything is fine, there is nothing to worry, and then we know what has happened on Monday, and then the kind of situation that we have seen. Though the government says, and we have seen that if you talk of the uptown Srinagar, there is a bit of relaxation. People are allowed, there are vendors here and there, and people are trying to buy whatever they can. But if you move out of those areas, you move into the old Srinagar city, you will find absolute lockdown. No one is allowed to enter, no one is allowed to move out. And in fact, it will be interesting to see what would be the strategy on Eid, though they're saying that there'll be relaxation. But we know that on the day of Eid, when people do come out, there is violence, and there are pockets of violence. But would that mean really keeping the complete Kashmir Valley or continue to keep it in lockdown on Eid as well? That is the biggest question that the government is staring at.
Yes.
But as of now, let me tell you, it's an enforced calm. It is not something that is naturally happening. It's enforced calm. Outside every door in the old city, you will find at least 2 to 3 CRPF personnel. So that is the situation on the ground. And that's why it will be interesting to see, once the restrictions are completely lifted, what will happen. But as of now, we're still some days away from that.
Yes, absolutely, Fareed. In fact, like you pointed out, once the restrictions are lifted is when we'll really get a sense of what the reaction is. But at the same time, at this point in time, like you were pointing out, there is a complete lockdown in most parts, except probably uptown Srinagar. But there are preparations being made to ensure that people are able to celebrate Eid. At the same time, Section 144 is still in place, if I'm not wrong. How is all of this really going to work? What is the state right now? Because Section 144 doesn't seem like it's going to be revoked anytime soon. How are people sort of accessing things, daily living? How is all of that happening?
Well, Tanvi, if you remember, there was panic buying in Srinagar. In the Kashmir Valley, there was panic buying, and that was not absolutely without reason. Now people would really come out and say that this is why we were buying. This is why we were stocking at that time. The government, as I said, there is a lack of trust right now between the locals and what the administration says. They do not trust the administration, to put it very plainly. Because at that time, the administration kept on saying that everything is fine, no need to pay heed to rumors. There is absolute rumor mongering that is going on, but the people at that time kept buying essentials, kept stocking things. Now this is what they could foresee. This is this kind of a lockdown they were expecting, and they were not out of place. Let me tell you, people do have essentials that are stocked. For 5-6 days there was non-stop panic buying. People stocked essentials, whatever they could lay their hands on, they stocked it. So there is no dearth of food and essentials, but there is no communication. I mean, if someone falls ill or there is an emergency, how would he contact the hospital? How would he get an ambulance? So those are the questions. And there are so many other issues that the people are confronted with, and it will be very difficult to really justify these restrictions for a longer period of time now, because it's already been 3-4 days. Valley is calm, though I'll add that it's enforced calm. So it is really a tight balance that the authorities are looking at. And the trust factor, or should I say lack of trust factor, would really not help things as far as the connection between the locals and the government is concerned. So that is really another big question. But on Eid, people do expect that this is a day of festivity. In fact, already people are suffering. You have the business community who were hoping to really earn something in the build-up to Eid. A lot of stuff that they had brought, they're down and out, they're gone. And in fact, people are literally being imprisoned in their homes. They do not know when this will ease out, how they can really go ahead and really buy something for Eid or really be part of those festivities. So that really is something that no one has an answer to. The government says that they will ease restrictions in the coming days, but since tomorrow is Friday, I do not expect any restrictions being eased for tomorrow. But from Saturday, probably there would be some relaxation, or people may be allowed out, but whether the shops will be open, whether 144 would be lifted, those are the questions. And how would the government proceed? How could the people really get this plan, that how will they move out and really buy these things or really think of celebrating Eid? So it's a very tough situation. I don't see Eid being celebrated the way it is every year. That is really gone. That's out of the window. But at least basic stuff, people are hoping that they'll be allowed to buy, and that is something that the government will have to facilitate. How they'll do it is the big question, and the answer maybe we get from Saturday.
Absolutely, Fareed. Thanks so much for getting us that latest ground report. Of course, we'll have to wait and watch when once Section 144 is in fact revoked, like Fareed was pointing out, and how long this enforced calm can be pushed by the government. But we'll have to wait and watch how that pans out. But like Fareed was pointing out, Section 144 has been in place in Jammu and Kashmir for several days, but government officials have been working hard to ensure that locals don't face any difficulty. Times Network's Siddhant visited Additional Deputy Commissioner Kuldeep Singh Siddha's office in Srinagar, where officials are issuing passes for movement of locals within the city limits.
Where Section 144 is in place in Valley, District Administration is working day and night to give relief to the people of the Valley. Right now I'm reporting from the office of Additional Deputy Commissioner Srinagar, and every single minute he is getting a request for a relief, and this is a desk which has been assigned where the complaints are coming, and he is handling it. He is giving instructions to the control room to pass on the relief to the concerned victim, or if somebody is stuck or needs to be rescued. He is Kuldeep Krishna Siddha, who along with the district administration is currently coordinating, and right now also he has got a request there is a patient whom he is helping right now. We'll try and speak to him. Siddha sab kya request aayi agar kuch bata paaye thoda sa?
This is basically a request that some death has occurred in Delhi.
Achha.
So we are just contacting their family over here.
Haan.
And we will extend all the possible jo help hai unko when the dead body arrives.
Haan.
Up to their residence and further jo whatever jo religious ceremonies hai, so we'll help them out.
Sir, aapke office se passes bhi ban rahe hain logon ke liye?
The office of DM is issuing passes to everybody, so we are taking every effort to make it convenient and make it comfortable so that nobody suffers either on account of personal emergency or any other accident.
In fact, Siddhant also visited a control room in the city of Srinagar. Internet on mobile phones has also been suspended in Jammu and Kashmir. Connectivity has been affected. Now, in the control room, officials are trying to bridge this gap by relaying messages to those living within the city as well as those living across the country. Police telecommunication network is also being used to relay messages to ensure that complaints related to medical, welfare and essential services are handled swiftly.
Control room of J&K government, all the messages are being received on these transmitters that are placed here on the table, and he is a very key person and a key guy who is handling all the complaints and help that are coming across the state. Not only state, he is getting requests across the country, those who need relief, those who need help. You can see these are the transmitter, and he conveys it to the local authority. So this arrangement has been made by the J&K government here in Srinagar. Name sir, thoda bata payenge kya hai?
Because the phone lines and other communications are not working, so we have this police telecommunication network,
okay,
which is connected throughout to within the valley and the state, throughout the state.
Okay.
So we are passing all emergency messages and relief other things on these through these wireless sets.
Okay. So whatever comes to the administration is being conveyed through these transmitter. These transmitter play a very crucial role. Sab subah se kitna request aa chuka hoga?
Lagbhag 50-60
logon ki madad. Sir, madad ho rahi hai?
Madad sir, abhi logon ko gharon mein mehsoor kiya gaya hai.
Haan.
तो अभी पता चला है कि पास दे रहे हैं कर्फ्यू पास.
हाँ.
तो हम आए हैं डीसी आप सभी वेट कर रहे हैं.
हाँ.
उन्होंने बोला एप्लीकेशन जितने भी यहाँ सिविलियंस हैं.
हाँ.
एप्लीकेशन भरे और डिपार्टमेंट से अलग उनका क्या प्रोसीजर होगा.
हाँ.
तो उस हिसाब से पास इशू किया जाएगा.
पर हो जाएगा पास इशू?
हाँ, 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 बोलते हैं पास
जी जी बिल्कुल. सब जितने भी मुलाजिम है यहाँ.
हाँ.
सब काम अच्छे तरीके कर रहे हैं.
अच्छा.
तो लोगों को जो भी इन तक जितना है इतना ये कर रहे हैं.
कर रहे हैं जितना बंद पड़ रहा है.
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल बिल्कुल.
The shutdown, however, continues to be a struggle for people in the valley. Schools are closed, public meetings are banned, roads and neighborhoods are still barricaded. People who are slowly leaving Kashmir also complain of being rendered jobless overnight.
पुंज में हम आए थे काम करने के लिए. हम पेंट के काम करते हैं जी. यहाँ पे बहुत हालात ख़राब है. यहाँ पे कर्फ्यू लगा हुआ है. हम लोग का कुछ हम लोग काम धंधा चौपट है, ऐसे काम खूब नहीं चल रहा है. आज हम लोग आपस जा रहे हैं घर को. बहुत काफ़ी दूर से हम लोग पैदल आए.
सर, हम पुंज में आए थे अपने घर छोड़कर मजदूरी करने के लिए. जब हम यहाँ से आए, दो चार दिन से यहाँ कर्फ्यू चल रही है. ना हमको काम मिल रहा है ना कुछ, इसलिए हम घर बिहार वापस जा रहे हैं.